episode of the Coiffed Cafe. Welcome to the mixing station. I am your host, Calvis J. Williamson. Before we get started with this co-wash mix, I just want to say thank you so very much on behalf of my husband and I for all of the well wishes and the prayers through our unfortunate loss of our baby. We did suffer a miscarriage. However, God is still good and we are still going forward. And, you know, hey, we have to accept what God allows. So we are moving forward. I want to give a huge shout out to Justin Young, owner of Real Natural Tees, for sending me this shirt. Don't stop me lying, because this is like something I would say. So I just want to say thank you all. Go by their website, www.realnaturaltees.com. Their information will be in the description box below, along with this co-washing mix. Now, there are a lot of people out there who don't like to use shampoo for whatever reason. Sometimes they think it, you know, it's harsh on their hair, and they just choose not to use shampoo. And so they do what's called co-washing, which is washing your hair with basically conditioner, because there are some cleansers in conditioner. There are a few companies out on the market that have listened to not only the natural hair community, but other ethnicities can be natural. They have listened to people who don't like to have a lot of lather. So all of the no poo or low poo folks, hey, the commercial beauty product people, they are commercial beauty product people. Them commercial brooded product people, they are listening. And so there are a couple of co-washing or co-wash products on the market that offer a little bit more cleansing properties for you to use. Some of the complaints against just using conditioner to cleanse your hair is that there's a lot of buildup, and that you have to eventually clarify at least once a month to remove kind of all the gook. This is just a way that you can create either a two-in-one shampoo or a co-wash mix that will allow you to cleanse your hair but provide your hair with other conditioning properties. So we're not here to debate whether or not co-washing is good or not. I'm just here to provide you with a co-wash recipe that you might want to use in your hair care regimen. So I'm going to do the mix, and I'm going to apply it to my hair. As you can see, I have my hair in some bantu knots. They've already been combed. It's already been, what is it called? I've been mixing all day. You see, I ain't even got my hardware on. And yet, there's nothing wrong. I don't need no Facebook rumors about the Coiffed Cafe people that ain't married. I'm not finna mess up my hardware.
Sure ain't.
Hell, it took me 30 years to get it. Anyway, my hair is already detangled, combed and detangled. It has dried, but this just allows me to wash easier. Occasionally, I will do this when I'm doing a deep condition, and I did my hair like this for co-washing, when you're just trying to, you know, really get in there and get in there with the section. I don't really have long hair, but because it's so thick and coily, this is the process that works best for me. So we are going to get to mixing again. Justin Young, thanks, bruh. And we're going to get to mixing. So I'm going to get my my apron, and we're going to get to it. Alrighty, I am properly fitted in my Coiffed Cafe apron, which is available on our website for $15, www.thecoiffedcafe.com. And I'm ready to whip something. Now, for this co-wash mix, you're going to need some type of thick conditioner, which is this. This is the good stuff that I got. My homegirl, Lalorda, she hooked me up with some conditioner base that they're testing. I have my extra virgin olive oil. I have some black JBCO, black Jamaican, or Jamaican black castor oil, and it's really black. It's not just in a dark container. It's dog. It just smells like barbecue.
Yeah.
Don't let them fool you. And I have some Castile soap. So this recipe calls for 3 to 5 tablespoons of any thick conditioner. Like I said, this is conditioner base that I'm using. And I'm gonna, I guess this is like 3 to 5. I know I posted a picture on Facebook talking about I'm gonna use measuring spoons and all that kind of stuff, but you know what? Big Mama don't use that. Big Mama use her eye and what's in her heart to make your macaroni and cheese.
Baby, go get that cup up out my face. I don't use that.
I don't need that. She know just how much a pinch of seasoning salt to use. So I have here, I'm gonna put about 3 to 5, and you can adjust the, you can adjust the recipe. 3 to 5 tablespoons of conditioner. Lord, I done ran out of conditioner. Dwafe, girl, I'm gonna need some more conditioner, child, for these wilts. This is actually conditioner base. So this is when people make their own hair care products, they use a conditioner base and then they add all that good, your good essential oils and all that good stuff to it. Okay, so 3 to 5 tablespoons of your favorite thick conditioner. Child, I'm running out. I hope she find it in her heart to send me some more. Touch her heart, Lord. Touch her heart. All right, so we got that up in there. I'm gonna keep this container. Use it for something. Alrighty. And then we're going to add 2 tablespoons of either you can use your favorite shampoo, be it sulfate or sulfate free. If you know that you've been co-washing for a minute and you're trying to add a little bit more cleansing effects to your hair, you might want to add some sulfate, a shampoo with sulfate. Again, hair knots is exit stage level before you even come on this post, because some people use sulfates. I will occasionally. And what are you going to do? Nothing. Sue me from some non-sulfate? You can. I'm going to use Castile soap for my hair cleanser. This is what I use on my hair every 2 weeks. It makes deep conditioning for me more effective because I have low porous hair. So this is Castile soap. So I'm going to use about 2 tablespoons of this. And I have my computer here because I thought I wrote it down on cue cards. You know how they do on the TV. But we do things different at the Coiffed Cafe. So I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons. That look more than 2. I mean about 3. Then I got my JBCO. This has been just wonderful for me. And that's really all I have to say. I love Jamaican Black Castor Oil. It helps my scalp with dandruff, keeping down overproduction of fungus on my hair. Keeps the pH level real nice and balanced on my scalp. Love it. So I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons of Jamaican Black Castor Oil, or you can use regular castor oil if you don't have Jamaican Black Castor Oil. So let's squeeze some of this up in here.
Up in here?
Up in here. Y'all gonna make me lose my mind. Up in here. And when you're adding products, especially the Jamaican Black Castor Oil, you have to go like this. Otherwise, it won't work. Does that look like 2 tablespoons? I don't know. I don't know. And, of course, I don't know what it is about olive oil, but a mix to me is just not a mix unless it has olive oil in it. I don't know what it is about olive oil, but I have to use olive oil in my mixes, saints. I'm going to add this olive oil. I have 1 tablespoon full of olive oil in this recipe, and that I will stick to because olive oil is like water. It can thin out a mixture. So you never go wrong with olive oil. That's it. Ooh, Lord. I don't know if that's right. Same. So I'm going to mix this all together. What's my time looking like, Mr. Cameraman?
6 minutes. 6 minutes. 6 minutes, Coiffed Cafe, you on. Oh my God.
And you gotta mix like this too. Alright. Oh. Okay. Does anybody know the number to the Apollo? Dang. Just took over. Got a takeover spirit.
It is what it is.
I'm gonna add just a little bit more Castile soap to the mix. It's like some kind of icing. Of course, you can adjust the measurements of this. If you want it to be more shampoo than conditioner, of course, you most certainly can do this. Do that. I've tried this recipe about 3 times with just this mix. And it works wonderfully. I really like it. All right, so we are done with mixing. I'm going to change out of my apron here, and I'm gonna change into another shirt, and then I will be back to show you how to apply this to your hair, or one of the ways that you can apply this to your hair. Right quick, let me take my apron off because I want y'all to get a glimpse of this tea. Again, thanks Justin and Carletta. I really, really appreciate it. And this is totally me. So I will be back in a few minutes to show you how I apply this co-wash mix to my hair. Stay tuned. And we're back here at the mixing station, and I'm about to apply the co-wash mix to my hair. My hair has been previously sectioned off into some knots to make it a little bit more manageable and easier for me to apply the mix. So I have in my handy dandy water bottle, I'm just going to spritz each section again. And each section has already been detangled. Well, it was detangled, I promise that I had detangled it. I'm gonna add a little bit more water to my hair. Oh Lord. All right. And I'm just gonna apply some of the co-wash mix with my hands here. Now, because I'm using like no scented products at all in this mix, the Jamaican Black Castor Oil is really doing the most right now in my hair. Lord Jesus. And I just rake it through. Get them little ends there. Scrub my scalp real good. And then I'm just going to twist it right back on up. Twist it up and then knot it right on back. It's very thick and creamy. Like, seriously, real thick and creamy. So again, I'm gonna take this little twist right here. Ooh, y'all can see my hair in its
in his bandiferous, dramatical state.
Raw, yeah. Uncut.
Yes, Lord. This is Juanita at her just lowest, Lord. Again, I'm going to spritz my hair with some water. And like I said, this is what has made my hair most manageable. This is the process that I go through to make my hair manageable. I wash my hair once a week now, or I cleanse it in some type of way once a week. I'm going to add some of my co-wash mix here to the hair. And also to my scalp. And just a word to the wise, for those of you who use these water bottles, listen, you need to make enough spritz to last you maybe a couple of days. Don't go 2 or 3 weeks with the same water and conditioner oil mix in here. I don't care what people tell you about it, you can use the vitamin E to make it as a preservative. No, when you're dealing with a water-based product, you need something that's going to keep the microbes from forming in your water. So you need like a citric acid, or you need a what's the stuff called? It's a sorbate. Potassium sorbate as a preservative to keep that stuff safe. And I'm gonna either have Lalordi Muhammad or Ayetta Crawford on the Coiffed Cafe so they can talk to you some more about the proper use of essential oils as preservatives and or natural preservatives you can use to keep your homemade blends safe. Walk around here with micro water. Child, we ain't got time for that. And in my water mix, I just have water and inexpensive conditioner. That's all that's in there. And I would imagine because, you know what, of the olive oil, because there's so many conditioner properties in this little mix. With the olive oil, I would imagine you could probably keep this on your head if you want to for a couple of minutes. Have like a deep conditioner. Well, actually, no, don't do that. Use it how, I'm telling you, use it as a co-wash, because I haven't tried it as a co-wash, like a deep conditioner. And I don't need nobody sending me no letters talking about it. They have any hair issues. I definitely don't have time for that. So use it as a co-wash. It will take a minute for you to apply it, but that's all right. And that's number three. So look at here. I'm gonna finish up and apply my stuff to my head. I'm going to rinse it out. And then I might spray some more of this on my hair, and then I'm gonna seal and twist with our hair shortening, our sugar foot hair shortening. Yes, Irene, we do have sugar foot hair shortening. That is the fancy version of our DIY Crisco mix video. It is available to you. Again, our website is up, www.thecoiffcafe.com. If you have any questions about this episode or any previous episodes, please feel free to contact us at the Coiffed Cafe. Hold on. Where they can?
Gmail.
Child, look. At coiffcafe@gmail.com. Wow. You can inbox us on our Facebook page. We're on Facebook. Just type in the Coiffed Cafe. We'll pop up. Or if you're on my friends list, hey, shoot me an inbox and let me know what's up. Thank you so much for tuning into this episode. Hey, we are still having fun here at the Mixing Station, and I will see y'all next time. Bye.